And there we have it. Without a shadow of a doubt, proof of Bernoulli's theorem.
Actually, I don't think that's the case.
Well, if you think you're so smart, then what is Bernoulli's principle?
Okay, so Bernoulli's principle talks about how the pressure can change in a stream of a flowing fluid. And here's a great demonstration for that. We're going to run air across this tube, and you can see that we've got the tube widens and it constricts and then widens again.
So we've got these are manometers. You've probably seen these in the lab set up before. They're just literally a water column. And this is a way of measuring pressure, right? If this is open to our region here, if this is a high pressure, it'll push this water column up and out of the way and you'll see it grow. If it's less pressure, it won't push as much as the atmosphere on this side. So you'll actually see the water column rise on this side instead. And so we should be able to compare these pressures at the different points, the large region, the region with the constriction, or the larger region again.
Right. What's going to happen based on the continuity equation is that as the air flows through this constriction, the size gets smaller, so the speed's going to increase.
Hit the air!
Okay, so here you go.
Oh, here you go, yeah.
So again, the manometer reads a high pressure on this side compared to the surrounding air, and there's a big pressure difference causing a big change in height for the fluid. At the constriction, the speed of the air increases, and Bernoulli's principle says then the pressure decreases. It's not as big as it used to be back upstream. And that's why you get a slight change in pressure, but not nearly as pronounced. Now, pressure is all over the place in fluids, like that page turner that you had there. There's pressure differences that cause the page to lift, but Bernoulli's equation talks about, strictly speaking, the flow in a stream and how the pressure changes with speed.
So then in order to actually talk about Bernoulli, we have to talk about very specific circumstances.
Right.
Wow.
So here's a great counterintuitive demonstration of the Bernoulli principle. We've got some air shooting out of this funnel.
Okay, so just to prove this, air shooting out of a funnel, it's not a vacuum. I've got a bunch of pieces here of paper, so I'm going to throw them in.
So you can imagine, just like the paper, if I put this inside the funnel, it's going to shoot itself out, right?
So. Mm-hmm.
Right? Not only is it not going to fire out, but if you turn that thing upside down, it's actually being held in. And this is, again, Bernoulli's principle. The air is flowing out through, and it's getting around that small opening between the ball and the wall of the funnel. The speed's going to increase around the ball, and that decreases the pressure enough that the pressure, low pressure here, is much greater than the pressure below, and it forces the ping pong ball up. Okay, so the walls of the funnel allowed us to have a constriction so that the pressure lowered as it went around. But here now, if we take away the walls and we just put the ping pong ball in this airstream. So the air is pushing up, counteracting gravity, but it's a lot more complicated than that.
So strictly speaking, this isn't just Bernoulli's effect.
There is a lot of stuff going on here. There's the air that's moving relative to the stationary around it. There's redirection happening. It's just a mess of fluid stuff going on here.
Still pretty cool though.
Yeah. So in all those different demos, Bernoulli's principle is a factor in that, but it's the details of the flow and the geometry of what you've got that really shapes up how much of an importance it is. I mean, in this demonstration here, where we've got laminar flow in a nice confined tube, and we see the pressure change with the speed, that there is 100% Bernoulli's principle.
Well, if that's Bernoulli, then what's this? Hey, get back to work.